Namaste and welcome to the Transformation Emergence on Holistic Wellness and Beyond. I'm your host, Sonal, a holistic healer and a transformational coach. Now, I'm very excited to introduce you to our guest of today, Deepam Jain, who is a very dear friend to me from Mumbai, India. Deepam is an energy healer, NLP practitioner, batch flower therapist, and a transformational coach. Deepam and I share a very good bond because of our so many common interests. And she is here to talk all about happiness today and to share how she found the real meaning of it. So let's welcome Deepam. And, you know, I'm so very happy to have you on my mega series.
Yes, thank you, Sonal. Thank you so much for inviting me and making a part of this Transformation Emergence series of yours. And I really love the concept or the topic which you have chosen this time, that holistic approach towards mental and health. That's really, really very important, and especially in the time which we all are dealing with. So thank you once again for having me over here. And yeah. So today what I'm going to talk about is all about happiness and what meaning we all have given to happiness. So if during this journey of our life, if I ask anybody, you know, whether it is, maybe if I ask you, Sonal, so it would be everyone has a different meaning towards happiness, and we attach meanings to it. Like, okay, if I reach this destination, I would be happy. If I have this car, I would be happy. Okay, if only my kids would do this way, the way I want, I would be happy. And things, when the things doesn't turn out the way we want them to turn out, we just sulk, we go back into our shell and we sulk and we create drama and trauma around us. So my journey has been a very, very exploratory one, where I was always doing everything for the people around me, you know, as you know that I'm a mother, I'm a wife, and now I'm into a profession. So I was always doing my best for each and every person in my life. And I attached my feelings with them, you know, okay, fine. If just as a smile, you know, being a female, I would, when I connect, being a female, we all be into that zone that, okay, if we just see a smile on our loved ones, on our family members, we feel satiated within. We feel, okay, our purpose is accomplished. So same was my story. I was a very good daughter, a very good mother, and a very good wife, and just doing my part of duties. But whenever I would be myself and things will not go according to what I wanted them to be, I would really sulk within. And in fact, there was a point of moment in my life where I was feeling depressed. I was full of anxiety. I was full of fear. Okay, because I had given different meanings to my happiness. I had attached with each and every person that happiness. If the things weren't happening the way I wanted, I would just definitely go into that depressing zone. And I thought, okay, my life has no meaning because things are not working the way I want them to work. And that's where I realized that something needs to shift, and there's something much more to my life, just despite being a good daughter, mother, daughter-in-law, or whatever the meanings we define as we grow. So then I realized, you know, I started exploring the spiritual realm. I went on doing different modalities. You know, I was on a spiritual shopping, you, I would say, that I did one course after the other. And what a change, you know. Once I went to a class and I just heard one of my mentors saying, choice, you're just a choice away from your desires, from your dream kind of life. And that put me in awe that how just being into that choice can create a big difference. And when I started contemplating that word, that choice, I realize, oh, how we just in our life, we don't choose at any given point of time. How we are always blaming others for our miseries, our traumas, our pain, our suffering. But nobody else is responsible for your happiness than you. If you take charge of your life, and if you decide in your life that, okay, It's my responsibility to make myself happy. It's not the artificial things. You know, we attach meanings like, okay, artificial happiness is, it's dependent on people. It's dependent on places, events, objects, you know, one nice holiday. And we will just go come back. But then again, we are into that zone. There is no happiness. One nice appreciation from your fellow worker, or maybe with accumulation, with all these artificial things, how we feel, okay, happiness is this. But these kind of happiness is just short-lived. Doesn't last long. The moment it is done and over, you are back into the same zone. So how just making that choice of being your own self can shift your whole perception about living a life full of joy, full of contentment. So this is what I discovered in my journey.
So Nipam, you are saying that happiness is a choice and it's always our choice. But then how come we are not choosing happiness, and like what is in us or within us which is stopping us to be happy?
Very good question, Sonal. And in fact, that's the thing which never anyone told us and never anyone taught us, that what is it? It's not with the outside world. It's not with the artificial happiness which we all run for. It's just an illusion. So happiness is all within us, but how much are we connected to ourselves? We are so much distracted in this world with the meaning which the world, which the environment, which our parents or the culture, everything has given to us. We have been programmed to think into a certain way. Okay, only if I have a very big house, I will be happy. Okay, if only I have that designer clothing, I might be happy. So that's just an illusion. But we are never reaching there. Why? Because it is deep down somewhere. You are not connected to yourself. When you are having that self kind of self-talk, that self-sabotaging effect, which comes from inner child conditioning, which I say when we come into this world and we have been programmed by our parents, because I would say parents, because that's the first relationship which we all have, which we all see when we come into this world. And for small thing, we look towards them for approval, for acknowledgement, and how we are pushed for each and everything to achieve into our life by our parents. Okay, only if you will get good grades, we will be happy with you. Mm-hmm. So, you know, our whole life becomes a pattern. It becomes a loop to just make our parents happy in each and every given point of time. So I won't say it's a parent's mistake. It is not their mistake, even because they are even not aware. We become aware and then we become realizing, we realize that, yeah, things are not this way. So today I have that kind of awareness that how it all began, how I was never satisfied with myself. I always thought that I am not good enough. I'm not lovable. I am not knowledgeable. I still have to achieve more and more and more to fill that gap within me and me. I wouldn't say within others. So if I would see a friend of mine accomplishing something into her life, I would just say, oh, I can't really do that. I can't do this because she is better than me or she has something more than me. But no, trust me, no one is better than you. It's just the difference between you and you. And only you can make that difference into your life, no one else. So the moment you realize, a person realize, okay, it's me. And the day I decided, okay, whatever happens into my life, I'm still going to choose happiness. Just that decision of yours can bring a huge difference. So the day I decided that I am always going to choose happiness, things started shifting into my life. I wouldn't say there was no problems. Of course, life is imperfect. Life doesn't give you bed of roses. It's the beauty of life, I would say. But the moment I decided, okay, whatever comes my way, I'm still choosing to be happy. So I would always look for the opportunities. How shall I react if that situation has come into my life? I always have choice. I always believe, okay, I have a choice to react or respond. I have a choice to sit back, cry, and stand up and rise. So when I made an agreement to myself, gave me a decision, gave a choice to myself, I started choosing the easier way out. And I, no matter what life gave me, I was always choosing what worked best for me at that time. So I would say, just, you're just a choice away from your desired life, from that happiness. And why not just to choose that? So nobody ever told me that I have a choice at any given point of time. We just, okay, so for an example, if you have an argument with someone, so we always think, okay, if I have an argument, I have a choice. I would not talk with that person, or I would distance myself. But when I say, okay, Sonal, you have a choice. You have a choice to just forget that and talk to that person, or just distance. So that is a freedom moment. Okay, that's, everything is in my control. If I am talking also, that's because I am choosing to talk. So you are not with those grudges. You are not with that, oh, she did that or he did that, nothing. Because you are taking the responsibility. So I would say taking responsibility, owning your actions, whatever it is, I am responsible for my action. That makes a difference into your life. And that what I would say made a difference. And if people knew that, okay, they have a choice. And most of the time when I'm dealing with my clients, they come with a very simple thing, you know, like, if the sessions are over, they will just simply come with this thing. Okay, you know, my daughter is not listening to me, and how do I respond? Because I'm always getting angry on her. So I just facilitate them. Okay, you have a choice. What do you want? What is your outcome here? Do you want her to listen to you, follow you, or just trust herself more? And the moment I just give them this word, okay, what is your outcome? Do you want peace into how, into your family, into your relation, or you want grudges? So when you know what is your outcome from that relation, you respond the way you want it. You are not reacting, because back of the mind, we all have that, okay, this is my outcome. So at every given point of time, we all have choice. And when you know the power of the choice, I think life could be really beautiful sooner.
So actually, the thinking behind your actions is the key. You know, before doing anything, you just think twice and be aware of that.
Exactly. And I think that is the key. When we are aware of the things which is happening into our life, you can definitely change anything.
So Nipam, as you are an energy healer, I wonder, like, what type of modality, or what do you practice?
Okay, very nice question. And as I just told you when we began, that I was in a shopping spree when I started my journey. I must have done, you know, 50 kind of different modalities, because I was looking for certain answers within. And you know, we always, as I said, when we are on a journey, we always think, okay, this will bring me that. And, you know, after that. So I have done plenty of them. But today what I do or choose to do with my clients to shift their energies is God's freedom technique, which is very, very dear to my heart. And I use NLP techniques. I use bark flower remedies. So when a client is coming to me with an issue XYZ, I intuitively connect to that client and see what will work best for them. So maybe it could be a combination with my coaching therapy and my energy healing, or it could be bark remedy and my energy healing. So I look into the patterns or the blockages which is creating the blocks into their life, and then I release with my energy healing tips. So this is my approach. So there is no set pattern. It's only client-centric, actually. So whatever is required at that moment with that person to be shifted into their life.
Very nice. And would you like to share some words of advice to benefit our listeners?
Definitely. So, you know, life, as I just said, it's an imperfect life, and no one has a perfect life. And it's just an illusion if you think that, okay, next door neighbor is going on a holiday. And, you know, I would just like to put it this way, that when I was into that zone that I never thought what happiness is, I would go onto the social media and I would just look over there and I would say, oh wow, they have gone here and they have such a beautiful life, or this one has designer clothes. So this was my internal conversation always to me. So it's not that, even they are empty within. Just being aware, what is the internal talk you're having? Just be aware. So awareness is a key, which is really, really important. Once you are aware, I think 50% of the work is already done. And then start journaling. Write down each a thought which is coming continuous to you again and again, again and again. Start writing down, and then you will notice the pattern into your life. Like, okay, you are having a kind of pattern of maybe self-sabotaging yourself, abusing yourself, or there's an inner critic, or maybe inner child. Something would be there, or some incident must have happened into your life that is bothering you, and through your conscious, subconscious mind, it is coming back into your life. As we all know that the unconscious and the subconscious plays a very, very important role into your life journey. So second, I would say journaling. And third, I would say have a vision towards your life, whether it is your financial situations, whether it is your business, whether it is your relationship, anything it is, just have a vision. What do you want? What is your outcome towards having that conversation with your friend? Or what is a conversation before stepping into that business or taking that financial decision? When you are aware of the outcome, you will be more accurate. You will be close to that, whatever you have visualized. And the last I would say, take action and stay committed to it. So if you have journaling, you have awareness, you know your outcome, stay committed. Take actions, maybe slow, but start from a baby step. So this will definitely make a difference into your life. And I have seen my life changing, and I totally trust that if I can change, anyone can change.
Thank you, Deepa, for coming on the Transformation Immersion. And it was lovely talking to you as always. And today also I learned more about the transformational work that you are doing. And I want to inform our listeners that Nipam is giving us a self-help guide on self-love. And so do download it and make use of it to empower yourself. Nipam, would you like to shed some light on what is there inside this guide?
Yeah, definitely. So it's a self-love recipe, I would say, that the things which are required for you to love yourself a little more. So almost most of the things I have shared, but there are certain key points which if you will use from that recipe, definitely you will be more connected to yourself, because remember, it's only you who can make you happy, no one else. So when you are connected to more to yourself, and we come on this planet for ourselves, and it is our innate duty to transform, to be the best version of yourself, not of anyone else. So that's my gift to your viewers. And I hope that they would definitely transform if they will download and just go through it.
So thank you to the people who watched this interview, and do let us know your thoughts, feedback and takeaways from today's talk on my Facebook community, Body, Mind and Soul Healing. And join it if you haven't joined it yet. And this is all for now. Bye. Take care and stay safe.
Bye. Thank you so much.